Welcome back to the Heroes of the Dorm. We are in the final game of the finals. It's been back and forth. It's not clear who's going to win. It's either going to be UC Berkeley or Arizona State. The games have been fantastic. And
tasteless. Let me lay this out for you, okay? These guys are playing for tuition for their college careers. There were 889 teams when we started this tournament. On the way to the finals, ASU lost a total of one game, whereas UC Berkeley lost zero games. It is now tied up 2-2. This could not be closer.
I mean, we've talked about nerves before. We've talked about them playing on the big stage. We've talked about them playing for the massive prize of free tuition for their college career. And now that it's down to 2-2, the pressure could not be more intense on these players.
Game number five, this is ridiculous. And in being in game number five, you can't hold any punches back. You need to go all the way here, bring out all the stops, and try to secure a win for your college tuition.
Well, one thing to remember here in Heroes of the Storm is that there are different battlegrounds. We've gone through a variety of different maps, each one with different objectives. The final map, which was picked by the losing team, is gonna be the map Dragonshire. Our D9, tell us a little bit about that map.
It's gonna be a gut-wrenching final match for sure.
On the small maps, we see UC Berkeley do well. On the big ones, we see Arizona State University do well. Dragonshire, the final map, is right in between. Three lanes with a medium distance separation, plus five mercenary camps give a reasonable amount of decisions and counterplay for both teams. But the shrines are on opposite ends of the battleground. Control them both, step into the center as well. You will free the Dragon Knight, a player-controlled pushing power, a player-controlled pushing mechanism. So the decision-making of these teams will all be in their hands. No help, no AI to guide them, and most importantly of all, I have no sense of who is going to have the advantage because it is, once again, a mid-sized map.
I don't think anybody is entirely clear on who's going to be the favorite here, but hold that thought. We are in the first part of the game here. The draft pick, each pick is going to then outline how this game's going to look.
Well, it looks like we have our first pick here for UC Berkeley, grabbing Illidan, a central piece of this entire match so far.
And Sylvanas, great for pushing, but most importantly of all, AKA Face snatching up Brightwing, the direct counter to Illidan.
AKA Face has been on point when it comes to playing Brightwing, and they know that going into game five, pick a hero that you've gone with the entire tournament and utilize it to your advantage. It's gonna work great against Fan. Remember that Polymorph, that Blink Kill, the two abilities that I believe AKA Face is using perfectly every single time.
Certainly does seem that way. And now UC Berkeley counterpicks here with Jaina, one of the best damage dealers that we have in Heroes of the Storm. And Tassadar as some backup here for Illidan.
We've seen this time and time again. UC Berkeley wants the big damage dealers first, and then they're going to see what the opposing team tries.
I'm wondering if Arizona State University is going to take Rhaegar here just because you want to take away some tools from Berkeley, but they go for their bread and butter,
oh, wow.
Diablo and Taronda.
The symbiosis and the team composition for the picks here is going to have for some very strong engagements as long as the execution is perfect. Let's talk for a second about Diablo, a very important initiator.
Oh, I mean, Diablo. You get to think about Diablo as the partner of Taronda. Diablo darts in, hurls an enemy overhead. Immediately, Taronda can stun. Even outside of that combo, Diablo is more than happy to be in the thick of things because of his trait, the Black Soul Stone. If Diablo has collected 100 nearby eliminations of minions, when he falls, he resurrects immediately. Diablo will almost always remain in the fight.
You see Berkeley falling up into the next composition, and yes, they're gonna get ETC and Rhaegar. They are here to allow Fan to take them out of game number five with a victory. Rhaegar with a healing. Oh, the luck, Mikey! He's a pick for Arizona State.
Lost, wow. Vikings, boys. It's time.
Let's get crazy in here. We are about to start the final game and crown a champion, champions, the Heroes of the Dorm. Let's do this on the mat, Dragonshire.
Let me hear you guys if you're cheering for UC Berkeley in the blue on the very far left. 10 seconds. And on the far right, Arizona State University. Let me hear you if you think they can take the game and get their college tuition. UC Berkeley seems to have a little bit more motivation here, a little more cheering. Arizona State University, though, going straight out of the gates, running towards a bush.
Well, I tell you what, they chose those Lost Vikings. I'm excited to see what they want to do. Look at this, a huge push immediately here, going forward as quickly as they can. But we see UC Berkeley using a very interesting strategy here.
This is a trap. They're hoping to bait him in. Doesn't work out. They decide then to split up and go to the respective lanes. Or maybe I spoke too soon. They might actually be going in and trying to engage right now.
Now, looks like UC Berkeley going to clear those minions as quickly as is possible. In the meantime, ASU fighting heavily in this lane. They do have one of the Vikings up top, really spread out quite a bit here to gain some experience.
And as a reminder for you at home, remember, Mike Udall is currently controlling three heroes in the middle lane. He's controlling the big dwarf that is a little bit on the bigger side, and his name is Olaf. In the top, he is controlling the other two as well. Eric the Swift and Baylog over here on the top right corner all do different things, but again, he has to use all of his focus here to make sure to control all three.
And I can't emphasize how true what you just said is. When you're playing the Lost Vikings, you're controlling three mini heroes on the map at once, which requires incredible multitasking.
Well, right now we do have a big push coming in from ASU, utilizing Sylvanas to shut down this tower, and it looks like they will take it down in a matter of seconds.
A brilliant push there early on to weaken the defenses. By the way, the Dragon Shrines, are now open. We already see the top shrine captured. The bottom not far away there for UC Berkeley if they decide to push this ASU scuffle here back and take that forward.
Well, continually scuffling forward here is ASU. Looks like they're going to be able to take down yet another tower here, gaining a lot of experience off of this.
And right now, they do not care about grabbing the shrine in the bottom. They know that Berkeley doesn't have it. They grab both the turrets down here, and even a couple of them start to rotate towards the middle. They're going to try and maybe secure that shrine, but they want to keep the pressure up on the turrets, keep that experience lead going forward as they just hit level 4.
It's important to note that you, especially in the early game here, you always want to have one hero in each lane because you acquire experience as long as the hero's in that lane, and the levels are actually share here. And that's why we have a bit of an experienced lead right now with a higher level 4 here for our red team ASU.
Well, looks like UC Berkeley, though, has both shrines. If they can get in here and get the Dragonite, that could be big. Looks like they're pushing into the center now. Fan darting forward, dealing a lot of damage to Fam. But looks like Melkor will push him back. Thing is, will they get that Dragonite? No! The bottom shrine taken by ASU.
I do believe it was one of the Vikings that snuck down there. It was Olaf. He grabbed this shrine. And we do have Mike Udall up here on the top lane as well. But remember, as long as one shrine is grabbed for Arizona State University, UC Berkeley cannot grab it. But they are moving forward with this experience lead right now. They are level 5, about to hit level 6 once again. And we have one more turret being taken out.
Oh, that turret, it will, in fact, go down there. Taking a lot of damage, though, is Melkor, so he's got to be careful about that. In the meantime, we do have UC Berkeley grabbing both shrines here.
Yeah, UC Berkeley in control of the shrines, but the center of the map here in control for ASU. ASU almost stuck now in the center of the map to some degree, because if they leave that, the Dragon Shrine will be captured. And of course, when you have the Dragon Shrine, you enter into the dragon's body. You are very strong, and you have a lot of push potential.
We just saw Fan grab a giant down the bottom of the corner, and that's going to alleviate some of the pressure coming from Arizona State University. They will have to go deal with those sea giants, but for now, they are focusing on getting more turrets. This might be the fifth turret they're taking out of the game before a 4-minute mark, which is insane for you at home.
Well, let's take a look here. We have a huge push from ASU targeting down a tower once again, dealing tons of damage. A beautiful Psy Storm there from Tassadar on Unlimited. Looks like they do break down through the gate.
I gotta say, the push in here from ASU is frankly terrifying. I mean, they are really able to destroy the gates pretty much. I believe they destroyed the gates in all three lanes. Am I correct about that?
Yeah, they have done that. And the opposing team, UC Berkeley, has actually started to get aggressive in the middle lane and the bottom lane. Let's go ahead and check out the middle lane. Although we do see some pressure up here. We see the four being taken down. We saw Fan finally take out some gates. He was tired of Arizona State University taking their own gates. And in the bottom lane, we had pressure from Suffy as well. So they started to trade a little bit here. They're trying to get the damage on. But in the top lane, the fort is still in trouble. Arizona State University is continuing to push it. And look, it's down to a quarter health already.
And it looks like it will be going down here. That'll be spawning catapults for their side of the map. They get a stronger wave, a stronger army wave coming out there in top lane. And that's going to be yet another problem that UC Berkeley's going to have to deal with. Secondly, we have to keep in mind that it's level 8 versus level 8, but as you can see at the bars here, at the leveling bars, it's actually much closer to level 10 right now for Arizona State. As you can see, level 9 just now acquired. So that's going to be a problem. Level 10, you get your heroic abilities. Heroic abilities make it much easier to win a team-on-team fight.
These rotations have been beautifully done from Arizona State University. They're going to grab the bottom of Shrine and, again, keep the pressure on the bottom four. And right now, really, UC Berkeley can't do anything until they get to level 10. But remember, they're behind in experience. So you see them just trying to get as many minions as possible, get that experience back, and just prevent Arizona State University from getting their own dragon. But look in the bottom left. Artosis, this fort, is taking more damage.
Yeah, it looks like they are going to be able to take that down as well. A four stack down here battling. A nice body slam there on Tassadar. Melkor backs up, and they will take down this tower as well, it looks
like. Level 10 has been acquired. This is going to be a huge lead for the time being right now for Arizona State as they're going to continue to press forward. The defense from UC Berkeley is going to have to be very, very solid.
Well, it looks like they're going to bash down these gates as well, and that'll leave just the keep in between them and the core. A beautiful push does continue, but level 10 almost here for UC Berkeley.
They've hit level 10. This means they can start team fighting. And UC Fan going back home right now. He's going to group up with his teammates. Ooh, a nice pick off there on Olaf. But he's going to group with his teammates and get into a team fight. They want to fight now because they have the power available to them. Can Arizona State University keep their lead, and can they fight accordingly?
Well, it looks like Melkor going to rotate up north there towards coming back down to this center lane. Still continuing to keep these four heroes together, pushing as strong as it can, taking down yet another gate.
I got to emphasize here, it's very important to note that the dragon has not yet been acquired here. Although, as I might be speaking too soon, okay, because that shrine's getting taken.
Uh-oh.
All right, here we go. They're going to get the dragon.
The Dragon Knight, now Kotank is piling it. He is pushing forwards, and this is going to give them a very strong push.
And it's important to remember that they are in complete control of the Dragon Knight, unlike, for instance, the Golem after full-on engagement's occurring now.
UC Berkeley engages, Fan chasing down. He's hitting the Viking live boat. The log boat is going to be taken out as well. UC Berkeley keeping up the aggression. Melkor in trouble. He's trying to fight his way out, but two members go down for Arizona State University. However, in the top lane, the Dragon for Kotank is keeping up the aggression, trying to grab whatever he can before the opposing team does show up, and here they are.
Kotank has to be careful. They're coming for him right now with his teammates not anywhere near him. He could be taken out. Kotank losing life here on the Dragon Knight. The Dragon Knight goes down, but can he get out of here?
Melkor shows up to help. He saves his teammate. The teamwork, the selflessness. Melkor moves in again, trying to start the engagement. Once again, if possible, no. Everyone from UC Berkeley is backing up, and it looks like we may have a couple seconds here. Ultimate is in trouble, but does get away. And now we're going to have everyone disperse here as they want to get experience and all the mercenary camps on the battleground.
All right, looks like right now, as you say, everyone is dispersing. Some of the mercenary camps being taken. Looks like the bottom center bruiser camp gonna be cleaned up here by Fan. In the meantime, we do have ASU clearing their bruisers up top.
We also had them grabbing these giants. So two mercenary camps here for Arizona State University versus the one here for UC Berkeley. So we're going to have to find a way to try to clean those up. But Arizona State University, one to keep the pressure up. They have all of their heroics available to them. And UC is actually missing a couple. So they're going to try and go for engagement. Melkor leading the charge here. There goes Fan. Melkor is going to throw someone back. There's a metamorphosis here from Fan. And the Viking longboat has been popped.
It looks like right now Melkor popping his heroic here, and it looks like Kotank barely getting out. Kotank, though, does go down. A beautiful pickoff here for UC Berkeley.
The heal was important there from Subby. Fan moving forward. Subby in trouble, though. Ultimate in trouble in the top left corner. The Vikings chasing them down, but Fan also on the far right. Let's see if we're going to have Ultimate go down. Ultimate is picked up by Baylog. Fan still chasing Brightwing on the far right. Zero in trouble as well. This is a bloodbath. Subby trying to get away. It looks like he may just do so. Let's go to the far right. What Brightwing picked off?
And you can see now it's a two on three just now as Heroes are beginning to respawn. So that was a bit of a trade. But, yeah, you're absolutely right, Tim. A complete and total bloodbath back there as this game begins to balance out. Dragon Shrine's about to activate in about 10 seconds.
Well, that's just about when all the Heroes will be back up again. So I'm not sure that anyone's going to get the Dragon Knight for a while. But already we have Jaina up at the top getting ready to take that shrine.
All right, one shrine here for the blue team in the bottom. We have the red team grabbing their own shrine as well. So again, this tug of war continues as we move to the mid game. Everyone's starting to group up in the middle lane here for Arizona State University. And Heroics aren't going to be up for about a 15 to 20 seconds. So watch for teams to play safe or try to get pickoffs.
Well, right now it looks like we are going to have another Viking grab that top shrine. They do have the bottom shrine. ETC on his way to try to stop that. We may have a little battle here. He's trying to get that Dragon Knight. Does get interrupted, though, and it gets shut down.
Nice job there at the bottom, taking back that shrine, and it looks like UC Berkeley may be able to push them back a little bit further now. Again, it's split as far as shrine control here, and that means that we're going to have to see the players all disperse, go their separate ways, and try to regroup and take control of those shrines again.
Melkor moving up here. He sees a tasty Jaina there right at the shrine, but Fan shows up instead. Here goes an engagement. We have a stage dive occurring.
And it looks like Archon mode now for Ultimated. It looks also Michael Udall going into his heroic, using that Viking ship, gets busted very quickly. And now it's time for Fan to use his heroic, going after Melkor at the moment.
ASU causing a split between UC Berkeley. The teams are cut in half. We see Suppy on the run. Suppy escapes, but back to the right side of the map. And they are surrounded, and it is a complete beatdown here. We see Zero trying to escape. Projectiles being shot. Will he manage to get back? We're going to see.
Looks like Zero may, in fact, end up escaping, but only he and Suppy made it out alive.
Arizona
State. But no, Melkor charging in. A nice slide, throw power slide by Zero. He is going to be able to escape, but we have five Heroes up right now for ASU.
And what they can do with this advantage is they can grab the dragon, the bottom shrine being picked up by one of the members for the Lost Vikings for Mike, and in the middle, another Viking, being controlled by one person, by the way, is grabbing
the dragon.
Dragon
again! The dragon is gonna push down middle lane! UC Berkeley needs to have solid defense to hang on, or this game will go to Arizona State.
Michael Udall going forward with this Dragon Knight. In the meantime, Sylvanas hitting this bottom tower. They are going to break through in a matter of seconds. Right now, UC Berkeley trying to hold on for their life.
UC Berkeley a little bit halfway away from getting to level 16. They want level 16 before they go into an engagement. And Arizona State University, knowing this, is charging forward, going for this keep. If they secure this keep, that is a huge advantage for them. But here is level 16 for Berkeley. Will they choose to engage? We'll see soon as ETC is coming from the top left corner. But the keep was picked up here for Mike. There goes Fan charging in, hitting a five-man metamorphosis.
It looks like a jump in here by ETC. The Dragon Knight does, in fact, go down. Melkor goes down as well. Michael Udall could be in trouble trying to get out of here. In the meantime, Kotank and AKA FaZe trying to escape as well.
You can see how they've once again now been separated here in this case as they are on the run. Really nice engagement there from UC Berkeley. If they were not able to do that, the amount of additional damage that would have been dealt would have been huge. You need to keep those remaining structures alive to keep that core safe. As long as you keep the core safe back in the center of your base, you can still stay in this game and put up a fight.
Well, right now we do see UC Berkeley grouping up, starting to push in towards the center fort. And we do have AKA FaZe and Melkor here with Kotank. They're going to try to hold on as best they can, but the fort does fall. Also, the tower does go down.
UC Berkeley now just wants to get a couple of forts. They've gotten one already. Nicely done for them. Finally, they're getting themselves back into this game. The bottom fort in trouble as well, but Melkor already here to defend, waiting for his teammates to potentially come down. And, you know, UC Berkeley deciding, I can't get any more forts. That's fine. They're going to the very bottom, and they're going to grab mercenary camps and potentially put on some pressure there, while we see Arizona State University grabbing mercenaries to push the top lane.
Right now, this is a crazy back-and-forth game. No idea who's going to be able to win this at the moment, but we have a lot of Hearthstones going off here for UC Berkeley. Looks like they want to go heal up, regain their mana, and then rejoin the battle.
And that means on the right side of the map, Arizona State going to try to get every single mercenary they can. They're going to go for the Siege Giants first, defeating them and then making them part of their army. And I think that's probably the best move you can have here. They both, on both sides, they need to regroup and recoup.
That is very true right now, Tasteless. Everything is looking good for both teams as all the heroics are coming up. However, Arizona State University might entertain the idea of waiting till they get to level 20, as you mentioned, to get the Storm Power. So everyone starting to group up a little bit here. We see Brightwing in the bottom lane, absorbing as much experience as possible. The other members all here, and we're getting there. We're getting close, but there's a wrench in the entire plan here as we have Shrines now spawning.
With those Shrines going up, we could see some real battles for them now. Earlier in the game, the Dragon isn't as powerful, but as you approach level 20, as you approach later into the game time, he gets big and buff.
It's important to remember, UC Berkeley once again in a bad spot. They really can make a mistake for about the next 2.5 minutes here until they can begin to catch up to the levels that ASU are at right now.
I'm just watching Arizona State University right now. I'm trying to figure out what they want to do. Berkeley, you can see their plan. They're just trying to keep one Shrine away from their opponents. They're trying to defend everything. And currently in the top lane, they're having to deal with this huge push that was coming from UC Berkeley earlier when they grabbed the Mercenary Camps. But now Arizona State has grabbed both Shrines. Can they get the Dragon?
They have to keep this center location safe. They cannot give up this center location as long as Arizona State has control of the two Shrines, because if they get that Dragon, the push power is just too much.
Yeah, that Dragon would be huge. You get a Dragon this late into the game, that's the type of Dragon that you'll see on the cover of Sports Illustrated.
Very strong, very buff, and quite a nasty breath. But Fan, now moving forward here, going to pick off a potentially one member. No, we'll see the Vikings run away. Now, ETC was able to grab the Shrine at the very top there, so that's going to delay everything. But now, here it is, Tasteless. Level 20 finally hitting here for ASU.
Now is ASU's a chance to initiate. They do have the option. I think they're going to do it. I think they might even try to just push the air through the bottom since they are a bit stronger. You know what? Maybe forget about the Dragon. You already have a level advantage. It's going to be up to USC to defend. And if it doesn't work out, you can always retreat and take the Dragon Shrines later on.
Very good point. They could force a team fight over here like this, but it looks like Fan and Panda are coming up from behind.
This is unorthodox. Fan going in, though, a level behind. Is it going to be worth it? Fan takes a little bit of damage there. Goes the Metamorphosis, ultimate chasing. Mike Udall trying to help out here. Panda gets focused down so quickly here. Fam, though, will be going after Kotick. We have two members falling for Arizona State. Fam does run away, but there's the Lightning Breath from Melkor.
Melkor with that Lightning Breath, but ultimated does slam. A beautiful heal coming down there from Suppy. A great save indeed. Fam chasing down Melkor. Can Melkor get away? It doesn't look like it.
Melkor getting low on HP. Melkor attempting to escape, and Melkor is going down as well.
The Vikings will be able to run away, and they're going to try and grab some experience. They're also trying to get someone in the top lane so they can stop this Dragon from being grabbed. But Fan, moving forward, you see Mike Udall using the two heroes that he has available to try and slow this down while the other one is trying to grab the Shrine at the very top. Let's check out the top Shrine. Is he going to be able to get it? Let's go to the very top and see. And he gets it. He denies it. One player by himself is able to delay the Dragon. He's buying time for his team.
That was a beautiful sacrifice back there by the Lost Vikings player to actually just buy that time. And not allow UC Berkeley to get control of the Dragon again.
Well, now we even have Melkor down here, kind of stalling the Shrine out as well. Really fantastic moves here by ASU at a moment where the game could end very quickly, but it looks like they may, in fact, get the Dragon.
They delayed the Dragon long enough for everyone on Arizona State University to respawn in the game. This means they can actually go into a team fight now where earlier the Dragon could be at their keep right now. So let's see how Arizona State University will handle this. This is do or die right now. Game number 5. Who is going to take this game to move on to get college tuition?
They are going to tear down the walls over here and make a much more exposed Arizona University base in the back right now. Although I got to say, actually, the good teamwork here from Arizona State, they drove that Dragon southbound now pretty easily.
Yeah.
So they're going to go for a little bit of an easier cleanup here, the turret at the bottom.
He's taking a lot of damage. It was a nice push back here. ASU really fighting like their lives are on the line, and well, they are. So that's good to see.
Yeah, the Dragon has to be careful here because of Kotick over there. He has a ability called Hunter's Mark. If you put it on the Dragon, it amplifies the amount of damage hitting the Dragon. So you see that constantly happen here. In fact, Arizona State University is feeling very, very confident. They're running up here, but they got to be careful because the entire team for UC is right around the bush.
And this would be a good location for them to pin them in between that bridge area. Now we're going to go ahead and see the fort up here at the north destroyed. And what I would say is a pretty good job here from UC Berkeley on cleaning up any remaining structures on the outer perimeter of Arizona University's base.
And suddenly, look how even we truly are. It's three keeps against two keeps. Yeah, there's a couple towers left for ASU as well, but this game is extremely close at the moment.
And I couldn't ask for a closer game. Remember, at any point in the late game, if we do have a full team wipe, that potentially could be the end of the game. So you're going to see both teams playing very safely. Melkor, though, has to be the aggressive one for Arizona State University, while Calzero and Fan will probably be the engagers for UC. So keep an eye on those two players.
Right now, we do see UC Berkeley moving north right now as a group. Looks like they actually want to clear these bruisers on their opponent's side, but this could be a mistake. Looks like ASU moving up, and Berkeley does back up.
Ultimated down here, going for the flank, by the way. It looks like UC Berkeley wants to go for the fight. There goes Fan running in. Fan helping out with the damage, and Calzero finally charges in.
Well, it looks like right now the Vikings taking a lot of damage. Illidan does pop his heroic here, going after Fam. Can he get him? No, Fam with some very nice micro blink in there from Brightwing as well.
Panda in trouble in the top of the corner. Oh, he barely dodges! Fam running back. Melkor in trouble as well. Fam doing front flips left and right. Is Fam going to be able to take anyone down? No, it doesn't look like it. Five members up here. For UC Berkeley member, Jaina was able to get away, and a dragon will be spawning pretty soon. They're going to pull back and grab mercenary camps. They don't want to overextend.
That was an absolutely beautiful escape and a great follow-up here from UC Berkeley, cleaning up these mercenary camps.
They're in a very strong position. They have all five heroes up. It's another 30 seconds before Kotank comes out. The Vikings, well, most of them are out already, so just a slight advantage.
This is also a moment where they can go ahead and take the rest of the mercenary camps. You see the siege giants down here. All the way at the south, there's a mercenary camp as well they might want to take.
ASU just waiting right now. They have 14 seconds until all their members will spawn up. They're just defending whatever they can. Right now, the top lane is the important matter, but the shrine's activating in 5 seconds, by the way. They're going to have to get ready. A majority of them are moving to the top shrine, while at the very bottom, we have UC Berkeley securing their own.
Well, if anyone gets caught out in the open right now, they are going to be taken down almost instantaneously. So these teams have to be super, super careful.
Yes, you're absolutely right. It may come down to just one more big fight. As long as it's an exchange that goes favorably for one and not the other, and is not simply put a trade. By the way, great job getting all these mercenary camps here. Really causing some pressure here. They're both going to be very conscious about their defense as the game goes on.
Looks like right now ASU is clearing this bruiser camp on their opponent's side of the battleground. Maybe they'll decide to push with that. Note, looks like they want to actually teleport home here with their Hearthstones.
Oh, gotta be careful if a member gets picked off. Oh, no, two members went home. Melkor in trouble. Fan chasing a member down. A nice stun there from Kotank. But three members are stuck here for Arizona State University. This is a disaster.
Oh, man, something went very badly there for ASU with Melkor going down. Kotank may not be able to make it out. Fan is on the hunt right now for blood.
And it looks like they may be able to deny a Tyranny. We're getting back inside, and we do have another kill there as we see a retreat, a safe and smart retreat here from UC Berkeley.
Oh, man, beautiful play there by UC Berkeley. The second that we see a mistake from ASU, completely punished.
Meanwhile, a huge push down here in the south. Let's talk about that mistake, though, for a second. They were teleporting back. Oh, never mind. Let's talk about this for a second.
Oh, no, he got a little anti. Okay, let's right-click again. There we go. Now getting the dragon, and this thing is beefy.
This is a 22-minute dragon. This dragon is so strong. It's going to be very difficult right now for ASU to hold.
And it's already there are two ASU players that are not in the game just yet. They're waiting to respawn after being picked there. They're going to go right for the core. They're focusing it down.
It looks like they may have enough damage to actually end this game right now. Panda in the Dragon Knight, targeting down this core. So much damage being dealt. Zero hitting as well. And
G! UC Berkeley has done it. They are your winners. Give it up for your heroes of the door.
Amazing series from from our team and went all the way to game number five, but UC Berkeley, due to a small mistake from Arizona State University, is able to secure a win. Look at the confetti. They're so happy, jumping everywhere. This is fantastic.
This is amazing. Come on out, guys.
Wow. Yeah. Wow. Wow, what a fantastic series. I was blown away. I love what we saw back there from UC Berkeley. It was such a good game. I don't know. I feel great.
That was the best series I've seen. How about you? I have watched and played so many games of Heroes of the Storm. That entire series, nail-biter from start to finish. The final game could have gone either way at almost any point. Both of these teams almost deserve to take the win.
All right, guys, that does it for us up here on the stage. For Trixler, Artosis, Day 9, and myself, Tasteless, thank you so much for joining us here at Heroes of the Dorm. Michelle, what's going on down at the stage?
Oh, I am here with the winners of Heroes of the Dorm, the Golden Bears! Tell me, what's running through your mind right now? This is huge!
Oh my God, the game was amazing. Just want to thank ASU for that great game. Thank you, everyone, for being here, guys.
Oh, man, we enjoyed that so much. Everyone was backstage, couldn't believe it. Also joining me on stage are members of Blizzard Entertainment's development team. They are here to present the Heroes of the Dorm Awards. Please welcome the co-founder and CEO of Blizzard Entertainment, Mike Morheim.
And now, we'd like to present these medallions to our Heroes of the Dorm. I want to congratulate Cal Berkeley on fighting their way through the brackets and on their big win here in the grand finals. Man, that was awesome.
It was amazing.
You guys obviously put a lot of training into this. Your strategy and teamwork were really good throughout the entire tournament, but really challenged in those final games. We're pleased to reward you with our grand prize, free tuition for the rest of your college career. We also made these epic custom medallions to celebrate your victory. Wear them with pride. You guys earned them. Congratulations.
Mike, and I want to say thank you to the guys up at the desk, Tasteless, Artosis, Day 9, and Trixler. Well done! I also want to thank all the fans here at the legendary Shrine Auditorium and to ESPN for bringing gaming to the TV audience. This has been spectacular. So, from all of us here at Heroes of the Dorm, have a great night, and we'll see you on the battlefield.